Let never a man a-wooing, when that lack a thing is free, a store of gold, an open heart and full of charity. And this was seen of King Henry, though he lay quite alone, for he's taken into a haunted hall 7 miles from the town.
He's chased the deer now him before, and the doe down by the den, till the fattest buck in all the flock King Henry is slain. His huntsmen followed into the hall to make them burly cheer, when loud the wind was heard to sound, and an earthquake rocked the floor. And darkness covered all the hall where they sat at their meat. The grey dogs yowling left their food and crept to Henry's feet. And louder howled the rising wind and burst the fastened door. And in there came a grisly ghost stamping on the floor. Her head hit the roof tree of the house, a middle year could not span. Each frightened huntsman fled the hall and left the king alone. Her teeth were like the tether stakes, her nose like club or mell, and nothing less she seemed to be than a fiend that comes from hell.
Thank you. bed now, King Henry, a bed you'll make for me. Oh, you must pull the heather green and make it soft for me. And pull as he the heather green and make for her a bed. And taken as his gay mantle and o'er it he is spread. Take off your clothes now, King Henry, and lie down by my side. Now swear you, King Henry, to take me for your bride. Oh, God forbid, says King Henry, that ever the light betide, that ever a fiend that comes from hell should stretch down by my side. The day was come and the sun shone through the hall. The fairest lady that ever was seen lay between him and the wall. I've met with many a gentle knight that gave me such a fill, but never before with a courteous knight that gave me all my will.